release of version 10A, Sony's Vegas Pro now contains a comprehensive, while yet still incomplete, set of captioning tools. Captioning media on the Vegas timeline has the advantage of placing the captions once and exporting them for many different uses, like DVD subtitles, YouTube captions, Windows Media captions, and more. We are going to take a look and see how to put these tools to work. This program will be broken into three parts. First, we will add captions to our timeline. Second, we will export them into different formats. Finally, we will look at working with media that has closed captions already added to it. Let's get started in Vegas. I already have a short clip on the timeline that we are going to work with. The first step is to make the captions visible in our preview window. Using the overlays button on the preview window, select Closed Captioning CC1 Primary. Turn on the overlays by leaving the button depressed. Let's add a single caption to the timeline. Position the cursor where you want to add the caption. You can use the Insert menu and select Command, or just push the C key. In the dialog, set the command type to 608 CC1. Then type your caption into the comment box. When you press the OK button, your caption has been added to your timeline. When selecting the command type, you probably noticed that there was a 608 CC2, 3, and 4 as well. You may have also noticed that when we set the preview window overlay. There are four channels of captions that can be used for data. Captions tend to bleed across their channels some, so channel 1 is used for primary captions and channel 3 for the secondary captions. We will only be dealing with a single caption channel, so we will put everything in the 608 CC1 channel and preview that channel. Now you can place your cursor at the next location and repeat the process until you have entered all of your captions. You could also place all of your money in a box and mail it to me, but both are not the smartest things to do. Let's take a look at my favorite method of placing captions. With this method, we can place a large group of captions in place very quickly. First, create a text file with the transcript of the media or audio descriptions in it. Divide up the text so that each line contains an appropriate amount for one caption. Each line will become a caption. I like to just cut and paste from the original script into a notepad text document. When finished, we save the text document. Now back in Vegas Pro, place your cursor at the location for the first caption. Go to the menu bar and from the File menu, select Import Closed Captioning. In the dialog box, select the file type as Transcript or QuickTime Captioning Text. Now locate and select the text file you created. Click on Open. Your captions will now show up on the timeline as evenly and tightly spaced command markers. We want to move all of those markers to the far right end of our project timeline, past all of the media. Click on your first marker. Hold down the Shift key and click on the last command marker. With them all selected, drag them to the right past the end of your media. If you inspect one of the markers, you will find that it has put each line from your text file in its own marker. It has selected 608 CC1 for the command type, and the time shows where it is currently placed at the end of the timeline. Our next step is to quickly place these markers at the desired location on the timeline to sync with the media. To do this, go up to the View menu and choose Edit Details, or just press Alt and the 6 keys together. This will open up the Edit Details window. In the Show box, choose Commands. Now click on the first caption in the Edit Details window. Then place your cursor at the beginning of your media on the timeline. Get ready to press the Control and K keys together. Play the timeline. When the timeline is playing, press Ctrl-K each place you want to drop a caption. Don't panic if they're not in perfect position. You can adjust them later. Once they are all dropped, just drag them one direction or the other to fine-tune their placement. One other way to add your captions is to have a service transcribe your media and send back to you a caption file in one of these formats. Now simply go to the File menu, select Import Closed Captioning, and choose the file and click on Open. Your captions are now in place. You can fine-tune or edit them any way you like. To edit a caption command marker, just double-click its flag. You have now seen how to add captions to your timeline. Next time, we will work with exporting your media with the captions. Thanks for joining me.